I was 6 years old, I broke my leg. And I was running from my brother and his friends. And tasted the sweet perfume of the mountain grass I rolled down. I was younger then. Take me back to when I found my heart, broke it here, made friends and lost them through the years. And I've not seen the boring fields in so long. I know I've grown, but I can't wait to go home. Old and smoking and rolled cigarettes, running from the law through the backfields and getting drunk with my friends. Had my first kiss on a Friday night. I don't reckon that I did it right, but I was younger then. Take me back to when we found weekend jobs, when we got paid, we'd buy cheap spirits and drink them straight. Me and my friends have not thrown up in so long. Oh, how we've grown, but I can't wait to go home.
So you know.
One friend left to sell clothes.
One works
by the coast. One had two kids but lives alone. One's brother overdosed. One's already on his second wife. One's just barely getting by. But these people raised me and I can't wait to go home. I'm on my way. I still remember these old country lanes when we did not know the answers. And I miss the way you make me feel. It's real when we watch the sunset.
Okay, now the mic is on. Oh, good old Ed Sheeran. Jackie and I were discussing whether or not the stories he was telling about his friends, like the sad stories, were real or not. I think they're made up. They just rhymed too well. He's a lyrical genius. So we're entertaining tonight. For family. So we're making apricot glazed pork loin. What are you reaching for? What do I need? With braised asparagus and some mashed potatoes. surprisingly quick. The thing about pork tenderloin is there's not a lot of fat in it. It's mostly just protein. Of course, we all know fat is flavor. What are the three things you add to make something taste better?
Salt.
Salt?
Sugar.
Sugar. Nailed it. Oh. Wait, is that from something?
No, I'm just genius.
Nice. You should be here on camera peeling a dozen potatoes. Because I don't actually know how many potatoes feeds six people. So we're gonna try a dozen. So tenderloin comes from... Thanks. The tenderloin comes from like the inside top of the pork, right next to the spine. It's not... Oh, thanks, Jackie. It's not a well-fattened piece of meat because it doesn't get used a lot in the meat. It's pretty stagnant muscle. It's like, you have the spine. This is the spine. They can root down this. It's like up and inside. It's like when you get a T-bone steak, it's actually a strip cut and a tenderloin together on either side of the rib.
What exercise do pig do?
A lot more ab crunches than pigs are known to. No, I'm just kidding. I don't know. It's like just the natural way they move and walk. It doesn't get a lot. So when you go to the grocery store, and I'm looking at the pork loin right now, and there's just not enough fat on it, which means not that much flavor, which is why we're glazing, and it's incredibly easy to overcook, because all the heat goes straight into the protein. It's much too much. Yeah, we should go with that. We're ink masters.
And read studies!
Oh, you have to do school stuff. So traditionally, there's a lot of fruit glazes that go with ham. Ham being served with applesauce, mustard, and fruit. Getting apricots. Just you need something to add to the pork because it's not a very tasty meat. Minus the taste. And you have to do yourself. Safety for the vegetarians.
It didn't bleed.
Safety first. Ooh, I took a little bit of skin off there too. Oh, that wasn't a playlist. I thought it was autoplay. Oh, there it is. I think the music is too loud. I'm turning the mic up a bit. Maybe the gain is really low on the mic. No. The gain is fine. All right. So the pork tenderloin gets cooked in oil with a little bit of salt, salted right now, to tenderize it. Then it gets glazed on the stove and then into the oven for about 15 minutes. So I'm going to start that at 5:30, which is right away. So once the potatoes are on the stove, and we'll do the rest. Okay, music down is down a little bit more. Thanks, Honey Badger. Contrary to the name, they do give a fuck. Okay, would you mind rinsing these potatoes a little bit? A quick rinse and then I'll cut them. No. I don't like that one. Okay.
No potato gets left behind.
Ooh. Okay. How many? Water. Just cold water, because you always start cooking potatoes from cold water. You will heavily salt it. Oh, and we bought a potato masher. So we can properly mash instead of using a fork. These are just Yukon Gold potatoes.
Ah! I didn't rinse them.
That's okay. Oops. This one was rinsed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, these are gonna be mashed potatoes. So it doesn't really matter what size. Normally, I like to cook mashed potatoes in a pressure cooker, but I do not own a pressure cooker.
Have you ever used one?
Yeah, at my mom's house. And she's gonna be at this meal. So she'll notice that they weren't done in a pressure cooker. No, she won't. It doesn't even matter how good or how bad, hypothetically, if the food was to be bad, mom wouldn't say a thing. Like, oh, it's delicious, Dave. No, mom. It's garbage. Actually, I don't think mom's the biggest fan of pork because of the fat in it, but this cut has a little less fat, so it should be fine. I think I added enough water too. 1 inch over.
Can you turn the oven on?
Yes, please.
Stove.
Oh, oven 400 Fahrenheit, please.
Convec?
Yeah. Might as well.
Do you want me to do like 425 so it's actually 400?
I actually don't know how it works, but no. Convection roast. Thanks. Thanks, babe. I don't know that we need the cutting board at all.
Oh, running.
No, Jackie, you have a nice face.
I have a study face.
Busy today. Okay. Oh, it's the wrong one. Potatoes are gonna start to boil. Once they are cooked, we just add butter and a little bit of milk. Good to go. Okay, this pan, I'll show you the pork tenderloin. This one, and it's been salted 2 hours ago, and the salt helps break down some of the proteins in the meat, so it retains moisture. Yes. These are gonna be cooked on the stove in vegetable oil. For just a little bit. And then we add the glaze and move it around for a touch, and then the whole thing goes into the oven. So we're making the glaze, which requires figs, prunes, brandy, apricot preserves. I need a bowl to put this all in. What? Are you making fun of me?
No, we have so many preserves, Dave.
My shelves are overflowing with preserves. I'll put this in a saucepan, I guess. Yeah, it's a nice cut of meat. It was a kind of expensive cut of meat too. Combine figs, prunes, brandy, preserves, and paprika. Let's go brandy first. Quarter cup. Oh, that's the thing. In Western culture, we cook incorrectly. We use volume and time to determine amount, so to cook, and we should be using, okay, I messed that up. This sounded really good in my head when I had talked about it before. Oh, where's the quarter cup? We use volume and time to measure and cook when we should be using mass and temperature. But those take a little bit more effort. So that's a quarter cup of brandy and a quarter cup for meat. Do you wanna sip?
Yeah.
That's not just straight brandy, that's a mix of something because it's sweeter than normal. Yeah, it doesn't. Ooh, it doesn't feel good.
My baba used to drink those.
Baba is grandparent? Grandpa?
Great grandma.
Great grandma. We called her Nana. I met her once.
No, you didn't.
I met my Nana once. Yeah, I didn't meet yours. Quarter cup each of dried figs. And dried prunes. It says to like quarter and half them. I'm gonna dice them up fairly small.
Not too small.
So these ones are the, oh, look how they ordered them. Like the big ones up top, small ones in the bottom, little braid. That looks like a quarter cup. And then dried prunes. These aren't necessarily dried, they're just pitted.
Oh. Are prunes not by definition dried?
What fruit do they come from? Like, raisins are dried grapes, right?
Mm-hmm.
Prunes are dried...
dates? No.
Oh,
plums?
No. Oh, maybe. What does it... Oh, we should just taste these. I feel like I'm 80. Have one. Honey badger. Oh, it's actually honey badger. It says they're plums.
That's right.
Yeah. I would agree.
What about the
sticky hands? Yeah. Let's chop these up. Oh, my poor cutting board.
Figs over.
Oh.
Prunes.
No. Oh, figs. Wait, am I supposed to do? Yeah, with prunes and figs.
They're good.
Wait.
Way better.
I'll just do slices, I guess. There's a lot of seeds in these. What are the ones I have in the fridge that I just haven't eaten yet? Dates? Oh man, where did we have dates?
A charcuterie place.
Oh, the hipster place. They were good dates. It was a good date.
Oh, I knew that was coming.
Nailed it. What's the next thing? Oh, a half a cup of apricot preserves. Ooh, nice. I might just estimate it because I don't want to get my measuring cup all sticky.
Half of this.
Half, oh, half of
it? It's 250 mils.
Nice. But what is it? Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, once again, volume. Ooh, do you want a drink, Jackie?
It's been a long day.
Should we open up some wine? Cooking with wine is always good.
Your mom doesn't drink wine, does she?
No, but she might have like a little glass.
Ooh.
Are you opening up the vinaigrette?
I thought you wanted me to.
Balsamic vinaigrette.
Do you?
Yes, please. It gets used later, though. That's apricot. The side. We do half a teaspoon of paprika. Grabbed it here. Oh, it's an explanation of the etymology of their name. Played a game. Name is Hannelore. Oh, I thought the natural name was Hannelore. That's the name on the game. I got a name for raging on someone. Oh, I got it. So it is related to Honey Badger. Two work ten eyes. So we have this, and I think we're just gonna kind of mix it together and then set it aside. Oh, 19 crimes. What? No? Yeah.
Well, I just feel like we should be watching some, like...
Oh, a monster movie. Is that why we watched The Godfather the other day?
We didn't watch The Godfather.
Goodfellas.
We can try it.
Look at that. It doesn't come across on camera. And in the real world, it smells like brandy. So, oven is on. Combine these and we'll set them aside. We dredge the pork tenderloins in corn starch.
Ooh.
Yeah. Okay, corn starch. And then heat the oil.
Why do you dredge it in corn starch, Dave?
Because it crisps up the edge, I guess. It adds, the cornstarch helps add browning. So I'm gonna turn this on to medium high heat with 2 teaspoons of vegetable oil. Yeah, it's that. 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil. Nope. 12-inch non-stick skillet. They recommend using one that you can put in the oven, but the one I have is only 8 inches that can go in the oven, so I'm just going to move it to a baking sheet afterwards. Okay. I have a plate with cornstarch. Actually, I'll put the tenderloin
on it.
And then fry it up. This is like, ooh, it's really smooth. It's kind of weird. It's that technique for, like, chicken. When you're cooking chicken in Chinese fast food. It's a very specific name for it.
Fried chicken?
Velveting. Chicken, you velvet the chicken. That's when you use cornstarch shit. Yeah, once the oil gets to temperature, that goes on there.
I'll add another one as well.
Over high heat until shimmering. Oh, are we doing a shot, Jackie? Jackie's feeling wild. Jackie's gonna get randy.
She's looking at me. Isn't that a term?
For like, maybe.
For what?
What is this? Strawberry daiquiri shot? Only 20%. Just don't want to spill it. Oh. It smells so sweet, but also like plastic. It was the thing, the split in the middle caused my mouth to leak. Oh. Not unpleasant. Asparagus takes about 15 minutes and is pretty quick, but we need that pan. Or no, we can use the other pan for it. Phone is there. Brown also has 12 minutes. Transfer to large plate and goes in the oven. Okay. Pretty simple. Asparagus. Oh, would you mind washing the asparagus?
Do you want all of it,
John? Yeah.
Isn't there more?
We'll have that bunch first, and I'll cook more afterwards. But we can't put all of it in a single pan anyway, so we have to do it in two. Alcohol consumption tight seems unsatisfactory.
Hmm?
It says unsatisfactory.
Well,
maybe. I mean, we'll be drinking more once the guests arrive. Right?
Anything? I think the oil's hot enough. So we're gonna give it a go.
Where do you want these?
Just on the cutting board, please.
Which
one? The one on the counter. I might grab a small lid to put over it. I don't have one. Okay, so it's gonna cook. We've done at, we'll rotate a couple times and at 554, you switch it.
And you just kind of rotate it around. So it's cooked, and the oven after that goes on. So I'm feeling flustered. How do I? Oh, all the butter goes in the asparagus. Okay, got it. Do you plan to have wine and beer? Yes, absolutely. Actually, I'm gonna open beer right now. Sleeman Honey Brown. Listen to that pork go. Okay, I'm gonna cut a little bit off the end of the asparagus. And we'll get the pan ready for it to go. But the pan is... The stovetop isn't quite big enough because the one pan we have for it is off this side. We'll put it on a medium heat and throw in 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil again. So when you braise vegetables, you kind of sear it and then steam it. That's what you're planning to do. Oh, is that a match without a head? It's not very useless. It's a toothpick. Oh, and then the gravy. We can do that quick. Pour the glaze in the skillet and cook, scraping up any brown bits from the bottom of the pan. Turn the pork to the skillet and turn to cook. Transfer it to the oven, turning the pork to coat it in the glaze.
Oh, potatoes are boiling. Turn those down so they don't boil over. And then, yeah, asparagus is going to cook on the back burner.
Asparagus takes 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil. So we just season, put them in the pan, single layer, season with salt and pepper, 1.5 minutes, flip, and then add stock and butter to the pan. And that's the steaming section. Okay, that makes sense. What's up?
Do you want my help, or?
This is actually a pretty easy meal.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you... I'm gonna go read a bit.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah. I just need to keep an eye on the phone because people will be here soon. Oh, my knife is way over there. Beauty. Just have to take out the thick, bitter end of the stalk and remove it.
You want me to take your phone?
Yeah, if you don't mind. It's 9 to open the door once they call. Quick beer handoff. Oktoberfest starts today.
We were there.
We were there on the last day, and it was so much fun. Just logging these. We'll turn it once more in just a couple more minutes, and then the meat will be ready to be, well, coated in the glaze. I feel like I don't have enough liquid in the glaze. Like, it's just kind of a sticky honey. Might have to add a little bit of water. Sides. Okay, and the asparagus is going to go into, it's a very high heat, until it's lightly smoking. Vegetable oil has a pretty high smoke point. Oops. So right now I'm streaming to Twitch and YouTube. YouTube is kind of garbage for discovering. Like, you only ever stream to people who follow your channel. It's not like Twitch where you can discover people at all. God damn, this tenderloin.
It just smells like frying meat. It's so good. Yeah, let me check the potatoes. Potatoes will be ready to mash when they're when you can put a fork into one of them and just easily slide in and out. Like that one, it's still like it doesn't hot water. It doesn't easily go in, so potatoes are not quite done yet. I'm getting sputtering oil. So I'm gonna grab the lid and throw the veggies on. I don't know where my lid is. It's too small. What are the big ones? Oh, it might be this lid actually. Yeah, they're using the same lid, it's dumb. Okay.
Here we go. Asparagus is gonna go in.
It's gonna sputter hard too. Yeah, I'm gonna put one in the show. Ah, it's a bit too long. I wish I had another 12-inch pan. Might have to do a couple of rounds. We'll hope that goes all right.
Another 4 minutes on the tenderloin.
Look at that. And then these are going to be cut into medallions to be served. Medallion just means slice it.
And it's round, so it's like naturally circular.
I should have cut the asparagus a little bit shorter, actually. That one feels pretty good, actually. Maybe not quite ready to mash.
That pan is actually much too small.
There we go.
Wait, gravy is going to be... It's just an instant gravy to add to the mashed potatoes. I don't have another saucepan though.
I think I have a tiny pan actually. There it is. We'll make that last because it warms pretty quick.
Okay. One sec. I need to figure out this asparagus.
I really need the right size pan to do this properly. What a mistake. Rookie mistake. Let it go for another couple minutes.
And the pork as well, another couple minutes. Yeah, I really should have cut it the stem shorter. Like I don't wanna have a stem of asparagus without the head. Like that looks kind of weird when you serve it. So I just should have cut the end off a little bit farther. Or use the bigger pan. I just need to invest in better kitchen equipment.
Wait. These potatoes are just about good. I'm gonna drain the water and then keep them warm. I actually cooked them a little bit too fast.
Control X goes to the right one.
Okay, tenderloin has done the first step, so it's going to go off to the side. So it's just cooked and browned all the way through. I'm going to turn this onto a low heat,
and I cook the glaze for 2 minutes just to kind of deglaze the pan.
So this is going to sputter as well, because it's really hot oil. Gonna move this around in the pan. Oh. A couple minutes till it's heated up, and then I add the pork back into it, and I put the whole thing into the oven. Let's grab a proper utensil. I'm just gonna scrape up the fond in the pan. Okay, now the asparagus is cooked. We're gonna turn down the heat a little bit and add in beef stock and what's the other thing? Beef stock and butter. How much butter? 3 tablespoons and then 1 cup.
Yep.
Yeah, asparagus is one of my favorite vegetables. So this is gonna explode as well, adding liquid to oil.
And away we go.
Not exploding. It's just calm down a little bit. It smells very, very sweet. I like it.
Okay, and I add butter as well. Grab 3 tablespoons.
Whole thing is just going to reduce so you get a nice
butter-coated cooked asparagus. Hopefully still a little bit crunchy on the inside.
Nice chicken stock sauce. Okay. These potatoes are good, so I'm going to turn off the heat, drain them, and put them back in so I can mash them. Just a colander. We really should have an actual sieve. I'm gonna pour tenderloin back into the sauce. I'm gonna move it around. Coat it with all that sticky goodness. What is this music? We need to skip this song.
No more cooking until the song changes.
Oh man, look at that, it's nice and brown. It smells very sweet. Then the glaze gets put onto the pork tenderloin after it's been cooked, or after it's been cut, and then served onto the plate. I'm gonna grab another baking sheet, and that is gonna go into the oven right away.
Let's see. Pour glaze into skillet and cook. Return the pork to skillet, turn to coat. Transfer to oven, and move every.
And rotate every 4 minutes. Oh, there's my baking sheets. Hey, Jackie, where are the baking sheets? Oh, yeah, they're in the pizza dough in the fridge. They're with the pizza dough in the fridge.
Do you need to do something
at home? Nope. We have this third one.
take it off. Where is? Wait, I'm gonna take the tenderloin. It's a little bit slick now. One, two. I'm gonna pour the glaze over it. Into the oven it goes.
It's at 559, so we're done at 615, and I'm gonna rotate it every few minutes. That one goes off.
Do I need this skillet anymore?
No,
I do not.
Cool it off there. Potatoes are good. Asparagus has another few minutes to go. Okay, now we do gravy in this one. Instant gravy, pretty easy. Package with a cup of water. Half a cup each, milk and water. Cook over medium heat until it comes to a boil. Okay, easy enough. I ripped it, but it didn't rip far.
My cut measure.
There it is. He's in place. I don't have the proper cooking skills. Milk, water. I'm just gonna whisk this up.
Oh yeah, absolutely, it will caramelize beautifully.
Has a couple more minutes left. We're gonna check on the liquid level. Still going well. Potatoes are good too. Mmm, yum. Good amount of salt. Now, with potatoes, milk and a little bit of butter.
Someone's here?
It sounds like I found mom.
Nice. Do you think they want to be on stream?
Probably not, Mom.
I'm gonna add a little bit more butter. So I want to.
Do they know the apartment number?
Yeah, I texted it to them. A little bit more butter to make them a little bit smoother. Tenderloin's gonna be done in about 10 minutes and then it rests for 5 minutes. And I have a potato measure. There we go. It's actually a pastry cutter. But it had the same shape on the end as the potato masher from the grocery store. So it's actually both. Oh, so much easier than a fork. Give the hot chocolate on the oven a quick stir.
Smells pretty good actually.
Okay, I think the asparagus will be close to being done. So hot. Well, you know, I should have probably taken the lid off this, right? Take it properly.
Asparagus is actually overdone.
it on a rack. That's too bad. Or on a plate, I guess. What did I do? I cooked it for too long. Probably too much liquid here. Become a little bit soggy and not as crisp as you want it to be. And try again though. I'm gonna rotate the pork as well. You know, it might not be too bad. Pork. Rotate, put some of the apricots and figs and everything on top again. Move the liquid around. Ooh, this is gonna be hard to clean. This dish is gonna get very sticky. You know what? We're going to try with another bunch of asparagus. We're going to do less to keep the pan less crowded. I'm going to dump this out. Okay. I'm going to use front burner. This one onto a high heat, 2 tablespoons vegetable oil. I'm going to give this another shot. Ooh, I'm feeling scattered. Finish mashing these Yukon Gold potatoes. Put a thermometer into the pork to see what temperature it's done at. It's done at 160, so we're looking at about an M rating here. Reach in and stab it. There we go. That piece of asparagus wasn't too bad.
Okay, let's try with these bad dads. Cut them a little bit shorter.
We're gonna lay them out nicely.
One more quick rotate in 3 minutes.
For the tenderloins, I'm gonna scoop the mashed potatoes into a bowl. They are ready to go.
Hey guys! You guys have never been here before, right?
No.
First time. No, I gave you apartment 212.
Did I forget that?
That. Okay. That was not coming back to my memory.
Oh, goodness.
So, yes. So, how are you doing?
Doing well. How are you?
Good. I mean, I know you showed me pictures, but, you know, it's never quite the same when you walk in. So, this is kind of neat.
Yeah.
Yeah. You always have, like, an idea of what it's like, right?
Yeah. Yeah, you do.
It's not quite a real record player with the amp and all that, but it works.
It's got a needle and everything.
Throw some music.
You're back to needles? Like, needles are back? Oh,
traditional one is what Dave was saying.
Right.
Yeah. Do you need help with anything?
No.
Oh, yeah? Interested?